Hallelujah. So today we are going to talk about Christian values that move the hand of God. Christian values that move the hand of God. I'll tell you that when we are asked the question, what moves the hand of God? Many answers come. The first thing people say most of the time is faith. It's not wrong. Hallelujah. The other thing people say, somebody will say purity. Because righteousness, if you are not righteous, God will not listen to you. That's right. Others will say integrity, love, compassion, and many others. But I have one answer I want to highlight to us today. One answer. If you can take that one answer and you can work it out, you can put your life there, you can be son of God. One answer I want to put at the top of the list, the answer I want to put at the top of the list is that God is moved by pure desire. Pure desire. I'm going to explain it. Amen? The Bible tells us in Philippians 2:13, God is the one who creates in us, who gives us the desire and the power to do what pleases him. And if we know that God is moved by his willingness, his own willingness. Therefore, whatever you want to do, that will meet the desire of God, will meet the willingness of God, is what moves God. Is what moves God. So, but what is prayer? Prayer is the expression of our desires. Hallelujah. Is the expression of our desires. But now, if your desire can be pure, what is the desire that is pure? The desire that is pure is the desire that is the standard of God that has no human ambition or selfish ambition inside. So if we want to move God, or we want our desires to move God, or our prayers to move God, we need to do what? We need to purify our desires. Mark 11:24-25 say, I tell you, you can pray for anything, and if you believe that you receive it, it will be yours. But when you are praying, first forgive anyone you are holding a grudge against, so that your Father in heaven will forgive your sin too. What is he talking about? Anyone you are hold a grudge and inside of you, you have to be pure. Two, when you are praying against somebody, it doesn't work. It will never work. If it works, it's the devil. Any prayer you pray against somebody that you have a grudge against, and you say that prayer is working, is, I'm telling you, you are the Satanist in the church. Amen. You are a general Satanist. So it's important that we understand the prayer is the expression of our desire toward God. So effectiveness of prayer is in our godliness or our closeness toward God or closeness to God. The closer you are to God, better your prayer will be listened or answered. Hallelujah. James tells us very well. James 4:8. He said, come close to God, and God will come close to you. Wash your hand. That means your action, what you are doing, purify them. Don't do what other people do. Don't do filthy things. Don't touch them. Amen. He said, come close to God, and God will come close to you. Wash your hand, you sinners. Purify your heart, for your loyalty is divided between God and the world. I'm telling you, it's like James thought he was preaching to the people of his time, but actually he was preaching to the people of all time, especially our time. We want God, but it seemed like if God wants to judge us or want to show us who we are really, we want the world or we want the things that doesn't matter to God more than God himself. Because when you want God and you love somebody, what do you do? You do what pleases the person. Hallelujah. And that James 4 again, verse 2 to 3 say, yet you don't have what you want because you don't ask for it. And even if you ask, you don't get it because your motives are all wrong. You want only what gives you pleasure. Let me name some. I want this job. But actually, it's not the money you want, but it's the position. Because you started school with somebody in your career, so you have a hidden competition with your friend. You want to reach somebody where somewhere down when you compare both of you, he's not there. Or you want money because you want to achieve something that have no matter to God. There's a lot of things. Amen? Or you want a car, or a friend of you buy a car, so you want another car. There is a lot of things. Or you have your colleagues at your workplace who buy a car. You want to buy a car that is higher than him. So there are some hidden competition that actually destroy us. Amen? Destroy us. And sometimes we Christians, at the way God loves us, God deny us those things. You want it, you pray, it will never come. Say, what is going on? It's because that very things you are doing, the way he loves you, you know that he's going to destroy you. It's not good for you. But still, we don't get the message. Amen? And today there are some preaching going on. Say, we are going to be we are the head now. It's true. But the way you are head, amen? What you'll be doing with the money? Look, people who sell their land, act of the apostle, bring the whole money and share. So the ambition to sell or the motive to sell is not to have money for themselves. Hallelujah. Ananias and Sapphira, they tried. What happened to them? Amen. So I want to put a link between the answers we give to our question. What moves the hand of God or the hands of God? I said faith, purity, integrity, love, and compassion. So, if you remember what we looked at last Friday, Sunday, we talked about faith, and when we put human soul, human flesh, and human spirit there. And we say faith is what? Faith is having the word of God in you and trusting it. Let me put it another way. Faith is downloading the ways and the will of God into your soul to replace your ways and your will, your willingness. Then, when you download the ways of God in you, and let's say right now somebody is sick. I'm not a doctor. I have no medicine in my hand. But God, the ways of God is that speak it, it will happen. Amen? But now, I see somebody who is sick in front of me. As I download that ways of calling the things into manifestation, it will come to manifestation. And with the power of God, I will just speak it, say, be healed, and the person is healed. That is the way of God. But the will is that, is God want to will that person, heal that person that day? Yes. You do, it will happen. Is that the example I gave you Friday? What happens? This guy was in a gang. He's not in London. He's outside London. He was in the gang. He did a lot of things to the point that the whole town knows him that he's a troublemaker. Amen? But now, somebody went and evangelized this guy. And the Holy Spirit fell on him. He changed. Today, he's baptized everything. But now, there is a case pending against him in what? In court. But now, they bail him once. They bail him two. They bail him third. So, Friday is the last. Either he go to prison or he can be freed. Because there's not a lot of evidence against him. But now, I wake up Friday morning. I have to pray for him. But God opened my eyes. I saw how God called him to be an evangelist, to win souls. And even he have been in some crusade already in UK here, where he gave his testimony of his life. But I'm telling you, this guy I'm talking about, he haven't got 6 months conversion here. But now, as I want to send him a message, something that good, man, I can't feel. I said, what is this? I said, no, I don't want to do it. All of a sudden, God opened my eyes to see what he showed me on him. The way he will be preaching in crusade, and people will be coming with wheelchair and dropping their wheelchair, their clutches, everything. As I saw that immediately, now is the word of God can come. The word of God is what God spoke. So I based on that, I released it in the air. He has been free. Friday night, he calls me. Why? Because the will of God is for him to do what? To be winning souls. But the devil saw how much he will be winning souls. The devil went and troubled his life. But God has a time. And as the time of God has arrived, you have been rescued. But now, so the higher court that is higher than any other court is the court of heaven. If we declare him free in heaven, he has to be free here. Provided that now his willingness is not the will of this, the ways of this world anymore, but the ways of God. So anybody who repented, if we declare the person free, there's no judge who can condemn the person. Hallelujah. Amen? So it's important that we understand this. That God can do anything. If we can pray for people with selfless ambition, with the will of God in our mind, God will do what has to be done. So I say faith. So when you download the ways of God in you, the more you download the ways of God in you, the more you become pure. Hallelujah. The more you download the word of God in you, so you renounce your own ways. You replace them with your own ways, so the more you become pure. So if you become pure, what's the next one? Then you have the inner strength. The more you have the inner strength to stand the ways of God, that's what we call integrity. Hallelujah, integrity. But then when you have integrity, and as God is showing you more of his wonders, then you love God more. When you love God more, what God loves more, you love it, which is human being. So you love God and you love human being. The more you love God, the more you love human being. To the point that when you see somebody, that you see the person in the condition, God will never like it. Immediately, God share his heart with you. You have compassion for that person. And the compassion is what will push you. When you pray, God will answer, because both of you are sharing the same mind and the same heart on that condition. So, what moves God is Christian values. True Christian values. True Christian attitudes. Amen? Revelation 14. Verse 5, 4 to 5. He said, they have kept themselves as pure as virgin, following the Lamb wherever he goes. They have been purchased from among the people of the earth as a special offering to God and to the Lamb. They have told no lies. They are without blame. Amen? So asking Christians, for more dedication to God or more dedication into God is asking them to enable themselves to be more prayer effective for their future challenges. Because there are challenges ahead. There are challenges ahead. You face some. Maybe tomorrow one you don't even know. But if you have more, you have God on your side. More you overcome the obstacle. More you overcome the challenges. But less you have God, more stressful you are. Because stress, what is stress? Is looking at the situation and find your own way and counting on your own effort to overcome it. As you count on your own effort to overcome it, and you can't see any solution inside you or around you, then you are stressed. But when you can count on God, what is God you can see? You have happiness. And people look at you, say, what does he have? Or this guy is lying to us. What is this? Yeah, because in his spirit, he can see something. He can perceive something. He can. You don't see. That's what Paul is saying. Faith is what? Faith comes from hearing. Amen? It's a demonstration of what others don't see, but a firm confidence in what you see. Hallelujah. There are somebody right now is not here. If I say, where is him? Everybody will do like this. But anybody who say, where is him? Nobody will say, he's here. Wherever he is, everybody points out to him. So if in your spirit you can see something, so you have the firm assurance of what you see. But now you are demonstrating it to people who cannot see it. But what you see is what is in you, what you download. Amen? So, brothers and sisters, asking you to dedicate yourself like what we do in the church is like pushing people toward God, more God, more God. Because I don't have time to tell somebody, God will do this for you, God will do this for you, God will do this. I don't have that time. I'm wasting your time by telling you that. How many things you need in your life? Maybe more than a million. More than a million. How much, how many my mouth can say? Limited. But when you have God, as soon as your desire comes, is it what? Delight in the Lord, and he will give you what? The desire of your heart. So the more you come close to God, the more your challenges are less. Hallelujah. And some challenges are not even challenges. Some issues are not issues. It's the devil that fool us that we need them, we need them, we need them, but we don't need them. Amen? Let me tell you, do you know that we have some perfume that are, okay, the one I know, maybe there may be more, that are in hundreds of pounds, just one small bottle of perfume. Maybe we have 1,000 there that I don't even know there. I don't know. But I'm not wearing it today. But do you know that somebody who used to wear that, this morning, if he doesn't wear it, he doesn't feel like going to the people who he himself gave the habit to smell that smell on him. He thinks that something is wrong. Hallelujah. So there are certain things we put our heart on. We don't need them. Hallelujah. We don't need them. So our attitudes and time in prayer must show God that he is God. What I want to say is that is prayer. We say prayer is what? The expression of our desire. But that desire must be pure. But now the time and the attitude is what show God that he is God. That must show God that he is God. Because most of the time somebody may think, oh, I pray 3 hours. You go, you are speaking to 3 hours, 4 hours, 5 hours, whatever. And nothing is happening. Do you think it's a formula? Do you think it's a calculator? No. You go and cry to God. Hallelujah. You go and cry to God. We are talking about what moves God. Eh? So we are in the attitude now, the attitude that moves God. Jeremiah 9:1. He said, if only my head were a pool of water. That means he prayed till his head is completely wet. Amen? And my eyes, a fountain of tears. I would weep day and night for all my people who have been slaughtered. I want to tell you that several Salvation Army officers in the past or in the last days asked their leader, General Booth, say, how can we save the souls? You know what Booth answered? He simply answered, try tears. Try what? Tears. When Jesus was praying, you can see tears. He was sweats to the point that I would say the sweat was finished in his body. So blood started coming out. Amen? The sweat was finished, but blood started coming out. So you want to save people. Pray for them. But when I say pray, I'm not asking you to go and just say words. With all your heart, you are on your knee, crying for them with all your love. Hallelujah. Romans 8:26. He said, and the Holy Spirit help us in our weaknesses. Hallelujah. Or our weakness. For example, we don't know what God wants us to pray for. But the Holy Spirit pray for us with groaning that cannot be expressed in word. But now when he jumped there, he finished 26, he went to 28. Just look at what he said. He said, and we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose. So sometimes, let me tell you, something ungodly, something bad happened to you is the will of God. If you know that you have met God once in your life, you know that God loves you, you know that you have touched God once, that God who comes in you when you accepted him will never forsake you. But sometimes he can cut you off certain things. He can deny you something for you to know as something is going wrong. As he is the only source you have. So what happens? Father, and now what he has, he can tell you. Hallelujah. So everything works. So when certain things are happening to you, please don't blame the situation. Don't blame anybody. Find out from God what is going on. Hallelujah. He said, for God knew his people in advance. And he chooses them to become what? Like his son. Who is the son? The son of God is a man of sorrow. The man that loves people. The man that cries for people before God. That pray for them. Pray all night. Pray always. And is in obedience to God. That destroy his own willingness and ways. And replaces the willingness and the ways of God to the point that when you see him, everything he says is what God is saying. Everything he does is what God is doing. And now he said he wants what? He said, for he knew his people in advance and had chosen them to be like that son. So that his son would be firstborn among what? Many brothers and sisters. That means the firstborn God. Not the firstborn woman. So we need to understand that verse very well. The firstborn, the human being who come on earth and become exactly, who reach the fullness of God first, Jesus. Amen. Zechariah 12, verse 10 says, "And I will pour on the house of David and on the inhabitants of Jerusalem the spirit of grace and supplication." The spirit of grace and supplication. That means they will be praying with humility, asking God all the time. There's a man of God, not many people know him. When Jesus appeared to him and gave him the mandate he has, but this guy don't joke with him, eh? When he started 18 hours every day, 18 hours of prayer and supplication and grace every day. Every day. You don't joke with him. He understands areas of prayer. Okay? Sometimes when he enter some car, he goes to places he wants to preach. He enter a car, the car will not start. Demon will damage the car. Because the guy who can... Things change in the place. Amen? So what I'm talking about, that's why I tell you that I'm putting this one Christian level, because the way I can preach it as well, I'll call it the lifestyle of the prophets. At that time, what I will say maybe is something else. Amen? Hallelujah. They will look on me whom they pierce. They will mourn for him as one mourns for his only son, and grieve for him as one grieve for a firstborn. So, when they mourn for the church, which is the body of Christ, so the spirit of this is what we need. We need to ask that, Father, give me the spirit of grace and supplication. The spirit of grace and supplication. You remember Ezekiel? God told him what? To pray for what? 390 days for Israel and 40 days for what? Judah. Hallelujah. But God said, even they will not listen to you, but do it anyway. Zechariah 2. Hallelujah. So, well, everybody, today a lot of people are saying prophet, prophet, prophet. You know what is a prophet? It's somebody who cries with a lot of love in his heart. Not coming and displaying with the gift of the Spirit. It's the fruit of the Spirit that makes you prophet as a God. How many prophets was before God? He said, God said, my prophet. We have prophets and we have his prophet. That he's calling himself my prophet. Today we have prophet of money. Because the motive is money. You have prophet of fame, the motive is fame. You have prophet of God, the motive is to satisfy God. Amen? Hear the difference of supplication and manifestation of divine power. We want to put the difference between supplication and manifestation of divine power. So, because there is confusing. I say pray. Like when I pray for somebody, for the person to be healed, I pray for the person. But when you go before God, what you do there is different. Because when you go there, you are not praying God. Because you know that you realize that there are something that is needed, but you don't have it. So you go before God and you are praying God to give that. So what God wants to give it, what does he do? He will download it into you. Then when you go on the field, the thing is you. You are charged with it. Hallelujah. It's like sometimes we can watch something on the internet. Sometimes we can download the things into the computer. So when it's the computer, with or without the computer, without the internet, the server, you can watch it. Hallelujah. Revelation 11, he said what? The prophet will be given the power to do whatever they like to with the nations. That means they will do it. The two prophets, they will do it. No, they will be asking God, God will do it. God, no, God will train them and charge them. They will reach the fullness of God. They will be all transfigured. You cannot be raptured if you are not transfigured. Amen? So we need to understand that that's why Matthew 11 verse 12 says, And from the time John the Baptist began preaching until now, the kingdom of heaven has been forcefully advanced, and violent people are attacking it. Violent people are people who go before God, and you are supplying God. God, please, God, please, God, please, for hours, sometimes for days. And the thing will come. And it is in you. When it's in you, as you pay that big price, you don't joke with it. So when you come, now you declare. And then now you manifest the power. If you remember what Paul said, pray without ceasing. But who said, the kingdom of God is not in word only. It is what? The manifestation of the power of God. So he prays all the time for people, asking God what to do, asking God what is needed. And then when God down, he go and demonstrate it. Amen? So we are partners of God on earth to take the earth for him with more tears. Hallelujah. With more tears. Because today the devil have entered the heart of a lot of ministers. And the ministers are telling people, when you are in God, his smiling is happiness. It's true, when you are in God, his smiling is happiness. But your source of happiness must not be the source or the same source of happiness of the worldly people. If your source of happiness is a source of happiness of the worldly people, there's no difference. There are something you see, they don't see. And you are happy. And the Bible calls you more than conquerors. Things are upside down, but you are happy than the minister of the finance. Say, how do you do it? Say, it's God. He asks you 3 times, say, it's God. 4th time, you will hide. Say, God, if you are really there, please. Hallelujah. Pray, ask God. Sorry, I want to tell you this. It's very, very important. I'm saying the same thing. Some people don't like me. And people, because they don't understand me. But I'm telling you, I'm the right guy. I am the right guy. Different than me, something is wrong. Hallelujah. I am telling people don't like me. Because sometimes when we are talking, when you are going one direction, the direction I will put you, this guy again. With politeness, they will answer me back. But sometimes it's bye-bye in their heart. They don't want to see me again. Or they don't want to talk to me again. But I'm the right guy. I'm not joking. I'm the right guy. I can give you evidence, but the evidence I want to give you, if I tell you, those evidence is by faith, is what I saw, what God saw. I saw, okay? That is the evidence. But I want the time to come for God himself to prove to you that I am the right guy. Amen? Psalm 69. Verse 3 to 4. He said what? I am exhausted from crying for help. My throat is parched. My eyes are swollen with weeping, waiting for my God to help me. That's David saying that. Hallelujah. But you know that when we are reading the Bible, most of the time, according to the level or the quality of our heart, we are focused on what can appeal to us, which is what can appeal to the normal man, a carnal man, a worldly man. We don't see where people suffer. We see where God answered them. And we are claiming the answer. But we don't want to go through the process. That's why there is no glory in the church today. Hallelujah. That's why there's no glory in the church. There's no manifestation of that awesome power of God in the church. We don't see the Davids around. We don't see the Pauls around. We don't see the Moses around. We don't see the Elijah around. Because the Elijah and the Moses, they have been through a process. We deny the process, but we want the results. But God is not a God that practices favoritism. So, brothers and sisters, me as soul, my spirit, my body, my fingers, my nails to God. Hallelujah. Every single thing, God, He knows that. Hallelujah. He knows that. Sometimes He have allowed the devil to try me a little. Amen. But the devil himself, he knew that he fell before he started. Hallelujah. I'm not insulting him, but I want to say that God have taken intelligence away from the devil. No, seriously, God have taken intelligence away from the devil. You see people all the time. When you see them, you see the glory God put upon their life. You go and work. At the end of the day, the glory keep on coming into manifestation. Just leave them alone. Why do you waste your time? Hallelujah. I believe he's wasting his time on your life. He's wasting his time. And you must know that if you want to attack anybody here, he's wasting his time. We will never retreat. We will never retreat. And we will see this land change completely. Hallelujah. You remember in the Bible, yeah? Saul went. He was on his way to capture David. He entered the sons of the prophet. He started prophesying. Hallelujah. This is how we want to bring the glory of God in London. You come from any purpose when you enter London. Hallelujah. You are never giving your life to Christ. Ribobo, ya ba yerebo, mama yereba baba yekete, obo roba. Yes, this is it. And when you enter, you everywhere you go, you can't stop. The land of Christ, makasiketerebo, and it will happen. It will happen. God is God. Amen. God is God. And we must not joke with God. Amen? Amen. I am not against anybody. Amen? Any preacher, any denomination, even including the Muslim, I want them to come to the right God. And we will do it. Hallelujah? We will do it. Because look, if I'm in the wrong, and somebody saw me in the wrong, and the person is selfish, the person doesn't think that, oh, actually with all the effort I'm making is for something that is not going to pay, and the person doesn't care, the day I discover that, it will pain me. You understand? It will pain me that he saw something in front of me that is not good, but he never warned me. You understand? But I won't do that all my life. I will seek the lost one of the kingdom. I will find them. If you want to be part of that, join me. Amen? So most of the time, the enemy will cause people to do things against you. But you must remain godly. Because the very person you are praying for the devil to discourage you, the devil will go and cause something in the life of that person to do against you. And may just say, no. Me, I know there are two countries. I know they are my babies. Because how people from those countries hurt me. I said, these countries are my babies. Because the devil wants to do everything for me to say, I don't want to do anything with people from those countries again. No, you are a liar. Amen. Amen. So verse 4 of Psalm 69 say, those who hate me without cause outnumbers the hairs of my head. Look at what David is saying. Those who hate David are more than the numbers of his hair. Many enemies try to destroy me with lies, demanding that I give back what I didn't steal. So what something God is doing in your life, that is good. They want you not to have it. But you have not stolen it. Brothers and sisters, what is missing in the church today is that we are denying the process, but we want the result. Hallelujah. Denying the process. So we want our life to move God. And the only way our life can move God is to change our hearts, to purify it, to wash our hands, to team up with God. Hallelujah. And we will see glory. We will see glory. Brothers and sisters, let me tell you this. God promised a lot of things to me. Amen? But even if I have to die today, I won't regret it. Because my mind and heart is not on what he promised to me, but it's on him. So if I don't have what he promised to me, but I have to die, or somebody have to kill me for his purpose, it's a gain. Why? What he promised to me is smaller than him. So when you kill me, I'm going to him. So when Paul is telling you that death is gain to him, understand? It's a gain. And somebody may say, oh, I want to punish him. I don't want, let's say, run on in our activity. Somebody say, he doesn't want to help me right now. Okay? If somebody doesn't want to help me, do you know what happens? I have to do it myself. But the person is blessing me. Let me teach you. Anything we do in church, we have our reward in heaven. Okay? All the time you are not helping me, you know what happens? At that time, you have no salary. You're getting poorer, 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 poorer. I'm getting richer, 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 richer. I'm telling the truth. I have the revelation of the word. I have the revelation of God. So if somebody is blessing me, I'm happy. Bless me. I want to share it with you. You say no, I keep it. Hallelujah. So brothers and sisters, be zealous to serve God. Be zealous to serve God. You remember David? Hallelujah. They went and took back what the Ark of the Covenant. But now the Ark was coming. The Ark had to stay in some house for 3 months. But during those 3 months, the way the Ark, in the presence of the Ark, is blessing somebody's life. What happens? David said, go and bring it back. I know good things now. Go and bring the Ark back. Brothers and sisters, I pray that the devil will never take your mind and your heart. For him to disturb you, and you will think, oh, this is too much when you come to God. He'll give you the strength. You saw it here. Sometimes I come, I have no strength at all. But the power will fall on me, and I will jump like now I'm 18. Hallelujah. 2 Chronicles 16:9. The eyes of the Lord is searching all the earth to strengthen those who have their heart committed to him. And New King James says, he searches to manifest himself powerful through those who have his heart fully committed to him. So when people are coming and demonstrating the power, know that it's because God have said, oh, as your heart is fully committed, let me come and demonstrate. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I want your life and your mouth to move God. And what you need for your life and your mouth to move God is what you hear today. Hallelujah. Is what you hear today. And you can move God. Hallelujah. You can do what? Move God. You can move God. And to finish, I'll tell you that when I was newly converted, people used to call me, they say, Pastor. I say, no, me, I'm not a pastor. I'm just a brother. I'm not a pastor. No, why are you calling me pastor? I'm not a pastor. Because every time when we meet, I'll be sharing the word among us. Okay? But I never knew that even a pastor is something good because I was just a baby. You understand? To tell you that, serving God is the greatest of all job. Okay? Let me give you the demonstration. Pastors have under their authority presidents, ministers, MPs. People come and ask them directions. Isn't it? I mean, servant of God. Hallelujah. But when you are pursuing any career in this world, God made it to the point that regardless of the career you are pursuing, you have to submit to his servant. Hallelujah. If you want God, you have to submit to his servant. So who is the boss? The servant of God. So anything you are pursuing, know that it's good, it's great. But the marvelous one is God. Who wants to serve God? Two people, eh? Hallelujah. Amen. Brothers and sisters, may God bless you for this morning. Amen. May God bless you and be with you. Amen. May everything the devil puts as obstacle, as priority, that is not godly, away from you, away from your mind, away from your heart. May God take you step by step until you reach your destiny. You reach that period where God will be using you, displaying himself as he planned upon your life before you come on earth. May everything the devil throw against you be destroyed and canceled this morning. Power of God, mighty hand of God, move right now and change all these lives. Anybody listening with all his heart to this sermon, let the person's life be changed and clean and made godly in the name of Jesus. Father, all we want is that our life to give you glory. Father, I want to thank you. May your name be glorified. Hallelujah. God bless you.